13 more days, and I'll be gone. I will ask my husband not to harm you and protect your king and your son. Don't worry. Please protect me. So I agreed. Malini, don't kill me, my husband, don't kill my children. I am afraid because my brother is dead. Now is the time when Sairavi is asking on her knees, begging on her knees, just give me 13 more days and we will be gone. At that time, the word spread, Kichaka is dead. Kichaka is dead. Deshe, deshe, manushyancha, vismita kichake hake, bhulvetva bahundeshan, gramanchana ranicha, dronan, karnan, krupai sardham, bhishvena jamahatmana, sangatam pratravis sardham, trigatteja maharate, duryodhanan sabhamati, asinam idamam pruvan. Messengers have been sent everywhere because they want to expose the identity of the Pandavas. If they do that, the Kauravas don't have to go for another 13 years of exile. It's a very delicate issue. It's a very dangerous time for the Pandavas. Just as you're reaching the climax, you know it is the most dangerous time. Just a few days left, and the messengers come into the court which has got Drona, Karna, Kripa, Bhishma, and Duryodhana, of course. Kruto asmati paro yatna tesham anveshane tatha atyanta dashanam nashta bhadram tubhyam narashamam. We can't find them anywhere. We look for the five Pandavas and Draupadi. We can't find them anywhere, king. I think they're gone. They're being destroyed by you successfully. We looked out for Draupadi also. We couldn't find the life of her anywhere. Drona says, Shuracha, Kritavidyacha, Buddhimanto Jitendriya, Dharmanya Satyasandhacha, Yudhishthira Varuprada, Dujeya Kalushurante, Rakshya Nityam Chadaivatai. The best part about the Mahabharata is the opposition is opposed to Duryodhana. Bhishma, Drona, Kripa tell him, this is a foregone conclusion. Your enemies will win for the simple reason. Mahabharata ki katha maham. Mahabharata ki katha
Bahuna kim pradapena yad
And There will be no manodukha, there will be no bodily pain also. There won't be diseases and there won't be bodies also. Find out. Dhanashilo vadanyasya nibruto hi ishevakaha. He is the one who is modest, he is the one who is full of dana, he is generous, he is modest, and he is the one who has got the softest heart. When he, wherever he goes, he brings joy and prosperity to the kingdom. Find out where it is happening. Devata Atiti Bhuyanu Sarva Bhutanu Raghavan Tattu Durgyo No Vakhyam Shutva Desham Mahatmanam Muhuttam Manu Sanchintya Sachivani Dhamukhani. Now I know what to do. This is what you want me to find out. Duryodhana is now celebrating. He is thinking very deeply. I call my secret messengers and find out where this is happening. Grihite Bodhane Nunam. We do one thing. Every time they think of the Pandavas, they're up to some foul mischief. They never have a straight way. They never have a straight path. It's never open, transparent warfare. It is always imagination, backdoor business. You know what we'll do? We'll go to Viratanagara as a sample to find out if they are there and take away the cows. When the cows are taken away, the Pandavas will rise to the occasion, because it is the duty of the Pandavas to protect the cows. All kings must protect the Gobrahmani, the Acharya. They have to protect the cows. The cow is the most important animal for us. My dear listeners, I went to a vegetarian conference and they told me that a cow in her lifetime gives 2 lakh glasses of milk. Please clap for us. We live on that and send it to the butcher. We have a goshala. The businessman came from South India and told me, Amma, please sell all the old cows. You don't know how to run an ashram as a business. I said, that is not my business. It's an ashram. I'm not running an industry. Please sell all the old cows. I said, sell your old father and mother. He was horrified. He was a billionaire. We preachers are not afraid, my dear listeners, to talk the truth. We can speak the truth to anybody's face. I said, once your father and mother stop earning, can you sell them? This cow during a lifetime gives me 2 lakhs of glasses of milk. How can I send her to the witch in cold blood? She gives me such a beautiful look of gratitude. The little goshala that is growing, they're planning a big goshala, a modern goshala. I always have projects because I have to live on. And you clap. And it is all the people, for the people, for the Lord. I hope you understand. This cow, whenever she is in pain and my cow would call me, the cow is not delivering, Amma, she is having a problem with delivery. I go there, Krishnaya, Vasudevaya, A Paramatmani, Pranatak Krishnashaya, Govindaya, Namonama. You great cow, royal cow, please deliver the little calf. I pray desperately and the baby is born. After the baby is born, I look at the Gomata and ask her, are you okay? Clear gratitude, I'm so tired. Big eyes looking at me like that and saying thank you. She will take 1 hour to say thank you. As you know, says it instinctively, intuitively. And she's licking the calf into life. That's called Vatsalya. I hope you understand. We use the word Vatsalya. Vatsalya is Vatsasya Bhava. Vatsa means the calf. She is licking the calf into life. You should see the calf that falls and stands and falls and stands and suddenly stands because the mother is empowered it with her own life, licking it. How can you not look after the cow? There was an instance when celebrity's wife said, I'm sending the cow to your ashram. I was very happy. Anybody sends a cow to the ashram, I'm very happy. I said, what is the problem? Oh, the cow has got cancer in the stomach. Let her die in your ashram. I said, she won't die. know what happened to Mary? When we asked the veterinary surgeon to come, he said she doesn't have cancer. The calf in her stomach is having a fever, infection. We will cure the calf and we deliver the calf. The lady wanted a cow back. I said, nothing to you. Charity done is charity for you. But the cow came to Gokulam and can't die. How can I ask Krishna to allow her to die? With Mary. Mary in Gokulam. That is how she was. She delivered a brown calf, nice calf. Why do I say all this? Because of the personal touch. I love the cows. And who taught us this? The Pandavas. The Pandavas taught us. I'm sure if we attack the cow, they will rise to the occasion. We won't harm the cow. We just take them away. All of us will go together. Six Maharatas. They are called Maharatas. Veterans on the battlefield. Imagine six of them taking away all the cows. When we do that, they will expose their identity. They have rights to the patient because Kichana is dead. There is nobody to protect the Virata Nagara, and Virata himself is an old man. That time we should do. That time we should exploit and find out who they are and where they are. Suktam Susharmana Vakyam Praptakala Vidambajaha Tasman Shikram Vidinyama Yoja Ikmavar Uttiriyam. Karna is always ready for foul mischief. That is the greatest part about Karna. People say, Amma is such a good man. But don't worry. Amidst all that goodness and charity he has, he always has an inclination towards foul play. Instinctively, intuitively foul play. Later on, I will tell you how Bhishma analyzes his character and says, all the slight things that you do are a part of your birth. You were born out of wedlock. That is the reason why your adharmic tendencies are prevalent. That is why you were born out of wedlock, my child. That is why you are frustrated, desperate. This is the other side of karma, which you see now. Let us go and attack them. And then we'll send them back for a 13-year exile. This is what they're planning. Adattagam susharmat Krishna vakshasya kashtami apare divase sarve rajan sambhuya gaurava namamyante yanunante kula gokulani sahasrashaha kechake niyate raja virata paramiraha param sambhavan chakre kunti putre yudhishthire tatra trayodashasyante tasya vakshasya bharatam. Gopal, it is at this time that the Gopalas come and tell the king Virata, the cows are gone, the cows have been taken away. Lord of brave people came and took them away. What do we do? The 13th year has come to an end, says the Mahabharata. The 13th year has come to an end. Tatastrayodashasyante tasya varshasya bharatam. It has come to an end. Susharmana grihitam godhanam tarasa bahuh. And he took away the cows, 60,000 Shashtim Gavam Sahasrani, Trigalta, Kalayanti Vai. All of them have been taken away. What do we do, sir? What do we do? Then Varada says, don't worry. We have a good team here, ready, SOS. The team is ready, life saving the team. Maya Yastram Chaturvargam Avaktam Rishisatrama Damshito Varma Thaya Padam Dinyam Yaham Gavam. Give me a chariot and I will go. Atacham, atamcha, param shura. You know how to cook? You mean how to cook?
Yes.
A wrestler cook is capable of fighting also. We'll take him along. He'll also be of use to you. Go sankhyam, ashwagantam cha, samyojaya tatho. Give us your charioteers, give us your chariot, and we are ready.
Viratam Anvayupacha Sahita Kurkungavam.
Virata was leading. He's very happy now that he's got four stalwarts, not knowing who they are, not knowing that they're the best warriors in the world. Arjuna can't follow because he's in Bhadrachuri. I hope you understand. He's in a woman's dress. He'll come a little later. That's the climax of today's katha. As Virata moves on, Sendanam Samsamaropya Prayo Bhima Vikrama, each
Shraddha is following the great Virata. Trayasva mojaya kshipram asmat pritikaram rupam ushitasva sukham sarve sarvatame subhujita bhimasena prayakarya tasya vasasya nishkriti bhimama sahasam karshi tishtatvesha vanaspati jana Very great warrior. He attacks Virata. Bhima says, "Shall I uproot a couple of trees and banish his brain?" Yudhishthira says, "Don't reveal your identity. Anybody who uproots a tree will be known as Bhima. That is his way. That is his strong point. Don't allow yourself to be exposed now." Tam hivo bhima karmanam susharmanam mahatravat viratam abhivikshetam following Susharma, and then Susharma has been hit by the great Bhima. Bhima says, "Nayam apa samachara maddo jeevita varhati kim nushakya maya kartum yad raja satam grini." I will not allow him to harm our king Virata, and I will kill him. Dharma says, munch dharma chara pramanam milite vayam dasabhagam kato hyesha viratasya mahipate. All that we want, that is the greatness about Yudhishthira. Yudhishthira does not want to kill anybody. If they are only asking the Susharma, who is the Trikarta Raja, just say, "I am defeated." Just say, "I am defeated" in public. Allowed. That is enough for us. There is nothing against him. You want to leave him. Let him go. Let us not take revenge. Atrivamaharatnani. Virata is so happy that he's been saved. He says, "You, Kanka, my entertainer, my stalwart cook, my stalwart table keeper, my stalwart housekeeper, I'm very grateful to you. Take all my kingdom's wealth. Take whatever you want. We are thankful for the Rupika Pravaka that you gave us. 1 year of shelter, sir. We are thankful for that." They don't want anything. Selfless people, of the people, by the people, for Dharma. That is how the Pandavas live. They don't want anything. He's so shocked that these men who came to serve don't want anything from him. Dharma says, "I don't want anything, sir. I don't want anything." And the whole country is celebrating. When the country is celebrating, from the back door, the 6 month Maharathas come. First came Susharma. The 6 Maharathas, among them, they are Bhishma, Drona, Karna, Kripa, Drauni is Ashwatthama, and Saubala is Shakuni. All of them come from the back door and start attacking the cows. When this is announced, a second climax is now about to be shown to you. Ashtavimshati ratram masam va gunamantatah yattat asit mahayuddham tatrame sarathir tatah kim nu patro arjuna saksha iti mamsyanti maham pari. Whenever a great writer is approaching a climax, he wants some comic relief. As in the Ramayana, you have Shurpanaka entry. So also the Uttara Kumara episode is a hilarious episode. There are some braggarts in the world who talk highly about themselves. And where do they brag? In the inner apartments where women are there. Then goes Uttara Kumara, who is a personification of cowardice, and Mother Draupadi is watching him. He says, "You know who I am? Far better than Arjuna. I can win any battle. Wherever I go, I have won battles. And all my enemies are crushed. What is Arjuna before me?" She's shocked too. She says, "Now let me take revenge." She also has, like her brother Krishna, she also has a streak of mischief in her. She says, "Now Uttara Kumara, this is the time for you to show your bravery. This is the time for you to attack, because it's only Bhishma, Drona, Kripa who are there on the battlefield. I'm sure you can easily attack them. Let's take a chariot and go there." Sairandri janasi mama pratamhi kaivena pumsam nahi sambalamyaham. And who will come with me? Oh, Brahmanala to be with me. She will come with you. You have to go with her. Oh no, I didn't mean it seriously. I was kidding. I was joking. I was just trying to impress the women here. She said, no, we could be very serious. You have to go. You have to go, and we shall not spare you. Tatasanarma samyuktam akaro pandavu bahu uttaraya pramukada sarvam janam arindamaham drishpat mahadev senam. Can you imagine a sena? Can you imagine a huge army led by Bhishma, Drona, Kripa, Karna, Shakuni, and Pratha? Each one is an army by itself. You understand? Bhishma, Drona, Kripa, Karna, Ashwatthama, and Shakuni. All six of them in alive. When he sees them, his feet are trembling. He says, you want me to face these fellows? These fellows are impossible. Parideva yatri manda sakashe samyasajina. He looks at Samyasachi, Arjuna. Trigatnan mepitayat shunye vani pranihayavam. Now you have bragged in the presence of men and women, and you shall come with me. I don't want to fight. Let them take the kingdom. Let them take everything here. Kamo harundu matsyana, buyan sa kurabodhanam, prasantu jamanarya, naravapi pravannade. Let women laugh at me. Let men make a joke of me. Sangramedha name kariyam, gavo gachantu chapi me. Let the 60,000 cows be lost. I have nothing to do with it. Ityukta, Pradavat, Peter, Tha, Ratha. You know, he just jumps out of the Ratha and he's running. There goes Arjuna to catch hold of him. You will not move out of this place. Now Uttara Kumara finds there is something different in this. The grip of Brahmanada. Why does he inspire confidence in me? Tam anvadhavadham tam rajaputram dhanandaya sainikam prarasan kechit. All of them are laughing, not only at Uttara Kumara, but Arjuna and Kamalachuri. Can you imagine? He has to keep the appearance of a eunuch. Imagine a hero of his stature, tall man, long arms with an artificial plait and a huge skirt, running after this Uttara Kumara, bringing him back. Acharya Kurpanduna. Drona looks at that Brahmana who is running after Uttara Kumara. Those long arms are very familiar. Best disciple. You can't forget the physique of your best disciple. But the attire is beguiling. What could be the identity of this unknown eunuch who is running in the middle of the battlefield? Akara Arjuna Seva Kriva Rupam Vivarti. But he's looked like a eunuch, and yet the physique is that of my great disciple Arjuna. Amaneshwa Devendra Maharshi Kadanjayaha. He's like Devendra among the gods and the best among human beings. Uttaram tu pratidham pradhavantam anudrutya dhananjayaha matrupashvam gamishyami. Let me go back to my mother. Matrupashvam. Please, my mother is very dear to me. No, says Arjuna. Aham yotsyami gauravai hayam samyakshame imam. You will drive and I will fight. You will fight this forbidden fellow who's standing there. Yes, I will fight. No one asks questions. You just drive my chariot. Do you understand? Yes, I understand.
Where do you want me to drive? To the smashan. Oh God. Bad enough sitting on this chariot. Bad enough facing all these fellows. And now he wants to take me to the crematorium. Never been to a crematorium. What do you want me to do?
That shabby tree there?
Yes.
Climb up the tree.
Oh my God. There's a corpse hanging up there.
Yes.
Bring down the corpse. Oh no, grandmother. The corpse. It's coming alive, the corpse is moving. That's what happens when you find suddenly a dead body rising out of the mortuary. Movies, movies, it happens, same thing. Why is it enlightened? All the weapons are hissing serpents. The weapons are hissing. Anybody who is not the owner of the missile statues, they will hiss. Pray to them.
Pray to them. Say that you have come for my sake. They will not hiss.
Now he prays. What happened to my wife now? They're not hissing. They're not serpents anymore. He brings down all the weapons. And he's asking him,
Tadaham Raja Putrasam Prishayam Paninatam Jnanamitma Mahapragnyam.
One thing about Uttara Kumara, he's a good boy. Good soul. Very simple, very naive, stupid, cowardly. That is why Arjuna likes him. He says, no, don't worry, Uttara Kumara, you're a good soul. Because you're a good soul, the missiles won't harm you.
Tesham Sundarjanabhyasam Sparshaya Sparshabhyasam Punar Punaha.
Again and again, he's touching the missiles. They are not hissing anymore. Sarathri, Kiviram Kiviram. Oh, tell me, Uttara Kumara. Uttara Kumara is asking, tell me, Bhagavanada, what is this? Who is this? What is this big bow? I've never seen anything like this before. This is Gandiva. Gandiva, famous, celebrated bow. There's a history about Gandiva. First, for 100,000 years, Brahmaji had the Gandiva. 64,000 years, Shankara had the Gandiva. And 85,000 years, you had Indra having this Gandiva, then 5,000 years, Soma, the moon god, had this Gandiva, and then for 100 years, Varuna had this Gandiva. Tasmacha Varuna Agni Prena Prakrityatam Tachoyam Agnina Pratimahavena Dattam Parthaya Gandiva.
Agni Deva gave it to Partha. How do you know? How do you know it was given to Partha?
Because I am Partha.
Who said you are Partha? How do I believe that you are Partha?
Aham tu Arjuno nama, Kanko nama Yudhishthirah, Bhima Senas tu Arlaha, Vitusthe Rasapachakah, Sailandrim Draupadi Vriddhi, Yadarve Kichapo Adaha.
Oh, you are the Pandavas,
but I want to conduct an identification test. I must find out all this on the battlefield, imagine, with all those heroes waiting there.
I want to find out whether you know your 10 names. Arjuna had 10 names. Explain those names now.
Oh God, Arjuna says, this is the limit. All stupid people are stubborn.
Etani Mamanamani. What are your names? Arjuna Palguno Jishnu Kiriti Shvetavahana Bivatsu Vidayapatha Savyasachi Dhanakaya.
I must tell you, many children are afraid of thunder. Intuitively, my mother used to be afraid of thunder, even in her old age. So every time she was afraid of thunder, I would chant the shloka. If you chant the shloka, the children will be fearless. Because Arjuna is the son of Indra, the god of heaven, who guides all the elements in the world. Arjuna, what are the names that you have? And what are the meanings of these names? Please tell me. And here is a quick review of the names. Dhananjaya is one who goes around and fights, collects money, and makes his kingdom rich.
because all his horses are white in color. He is called Kiriti because he wears a lovely crown. On the battlefield, you see one of those graphic scenes where Karna and Arjuna are fighting. I can never forget that scene. Very easy for my friend Vyas Shukla to direct, because when Vyasari has given us the entire scene, graphic, point-to-point detail, step by step you have the detail of the war, and that is why it's easy to portray. The great one called Karna sends a missile, and there you have Arjuna's beautiful kirita knocked off. And when his kirita is knocked off, lovely curls of hair tumble down, says the Mahabharata. And as they tumble down, he looks more handsome than ever. But on the battlefield, it is necessary that you should have a headdress. Quickly he takes a silken cloth and makes a turban for himself. The turban looks more beautiful than the crown, says yes. This is the way the Mahabharata graphically describes the kirita. The kirita, that's why it's called kiriti. Bhimansu, very important part about his career. When a man fights, he just wants to kill his enemy. But where Arjuna is concerned, he says, I defeat my enemy, I kill him, but I don't amputate his body, distort his body. I don't cut off the limbs, I don't deform him. That's why it's called Bhimansu. There is another name for him, Savyasachi. He can wield arrows with both hands, and he's the one who's got lovely face, lovely form. That's why he's called Arjuna. He was born Uttarabhyam cha Purvabhyam Falguni Bhyam Aham Diva Jato Himavatam Prishne Tenamam Falgunam Viduhu. Between the Uttara Falguni and the Purva Falguni Nakshatra he was born, so he is known as Falguna. That is why I was known as Falguna. And then he says, these are my names. These are the meanings of my name. Uttara Kumar is very happy. I am convinced that you are Arjuna. I will ask Karishe Vachanandama. Yours obediently, sir, do whatever you say, whatever you want, and I will do it for you. Dasoham Deva Vishyami Pashyamam Anukampayam. Bahunan Kipranapena Shurume Paramam Vachaha Namah Vivem Kaunteya Sakshat Vishakakrutu. When you have an ally like Arjuna, you are not afraid. The coward has become emboldened. The coward says, sir, I am not afraid even of Indra. What about these fellows? These are mortals. I'm not afraid because you are with me. Arjuna is very happy that he has inspired confidence in the coward. Don't you remember? Sugriva goes to the portals of Bali and calls out, you brother, come out to have a duel with me. Bali is asking his wise diplomat, Dada, who is this? It's your brother, sir. What emboldens my cowardly brother? Vali, you will not win. Don't say that, woman. Don't you say that. You have never said a thing like that before. Unfortunately, Vali, I have to say this. Why? Because your brother has wisely chosen the Lord as his ally. He When does a party win? When does a warrior win? It depends on his allies. Who is drawn with him? Rama has given him the assurance that he will win. So Sugriva will win. Arjuna is with Brahma, the great one called Uttara. So Uttara is no more a coward. He knows that he is going to win. Anaham Vivevika Uteya Sakshara Vishatakruto. The Shami Vriksha, I told you, it's a very pure Vriksha which gives prosperity and joy to all those who bow down to it. That is why even today, on the Dasara day, Vijayadashmi day, as I told you, the king of Mysore on an elephant goes around the tree and then comes back to the darbar and gives the small pieces of the shami vriksha leaves to all the darbar people so that they get the best for the year to come. The Mahabharata is telling us they bow down and then went for a fight, went for the war. Bharatvaja tato drona sarva shatru tamvaraha aupattikam idam rajan nimittam bhavati hanaha nahi pashyam vijayam saimye asmakam param tapa shastrani prakashante na pravishyanti vahana.
Drona is feeling depressed for the first time, diffident for the first time. Sometimes you have heard of the wise saying, the father wants to be by the son and the guru by the shishya. Today Drona is saying, my horses are not happy, my weapons are not shining. That means I am being overpowered by an overpowering enemy. My enemy is so powerful that my weapons are not cooperating, my horses are not cooperating, they are not happy. Otherwise the happy horses take you to victory. My horses are refusing because it's Arjuna. They know who Arjuna is. They know the superior enemy who's standing in front of them.
Vishanna mukha bhuishna sarve yodha vichetasaha.
Why are all our soldiers looking so woebegone? I don't know what is happening. Uptoyam adma acharya maya karme na chasakar shitte shanta natava nivritta vatsaras satrayodashaha. Now we know, says Duryodhana. If we find out who they are and if we know it is the Pandavas, they have to go back for another banishment, 13 years. Karna says, we will see that they go back. It is at that time, Kripa says,
ekarcha panchavarshani brahmacharya maya charat eka suvadra marupya dvairahe krutna mahapayat saindhavam vanamasetu jitma krishna mathayat eka gandharva rajanam chitra senam marindamah.
Whenever there is an altercation between Karna and Bhishma, Drona and Kripa, Karna is up to some foul words. There is a streak of impertinence in Karna. Karna doesn't respect elders. When he walks into the sabha, that is the way he does not speak. He doesn't salute them, doesn't bow down to them, doesn't accept them as his superiors. This is always there. This altercation between particularly Kripa, Drona and Bhishma and Karna. This is always there. Now is an occasion when Karna is bragging, I can defeat Arjuna anywhere. Kripa says, stop right. You know what Arjuna is capable of? Ekarcha panchavarshani brahmacharyam acharayate. Alone, he observed celibacy for 5 years.
Eka suvadra arupya.
Alone, he kidnapped Suvadra and faced the entire army. Alone, he defeated Jayadratha, who was trying to kidnap Draupadi.
Eko gandharva rajanam chitrasenam palindamah.
When Chitrasena had attacked Duryodhana, alone the great Arjuna saved him.
Tadrisham karnayam paatham yodha vichet sudarmati dhudat sudarmati drono duryodhano vishma bhavan dravnittatavayam.
I don't think we can ever fight against this great one called Arjuna. He is invincible.
Bhikshyam harasva nityam tvam.
Karna has a foul tongue. You Brahmin, leave your bow and arrow. Abandon your weapons and go and beg in the streets of Hastinapura. You Brahmins and beggars, that is what you are worth for. Kripa says, you fellow, you are insulting a Kripacharya who is an ace warrior.
Tanaham niharishyami bhavatam gamyatam gruham.
You go away and I will win the battle, he said. Ashwatthama says, no, this should not happen. You should never insult an acharya of this type. Every now and then, Karna is only piling up his sins. Every now and then. The curse of the Brahmin, the curse of the acharya, all the ill goes into his bad balance. All this is going to be
minus points are more than the plus points. That is why, in spite of the enormous charity that he gives, all these weaknesses, particularly his foul tongue, he loves to hurt elders. And when elders curse, you can never escape the curse. Bhishma is also unhappy. Tesham kala tirekena jyotisham cha vyatikrama panchame panchame varshe gomasa adimasakaum. Don't worry, Arjuna and the other Pandavas, particularly Yudhishthira, are well versed in Jyotishastra. They have calculated. Every now and then you have the adhikamasa, I hope you know, one extra masa, one extra month, calculating all together till yesterday the 13th year was over, says Bhishma. Till yesterday the 13th year was over. That is why Arjuna made bold to come on the battlefield, otherwise he would not have revealed his identity. Guru Yukmaram Partha Na Amrutatvam Kathanchana. Bhishma is making a very categorical statement. The Pandavas would rather die than tell a lie. Pandavas would rather die than tell a lie. What a way of complimenting them. They are so brave. Naam Rajyam Pradasyami. Now is the time for you to give up your kingdom to them. Their rights, their prerogatives. No, says Duryodhana. I will not give anything to them. I will not give a single piece of ground to them. Naam Rajyam Pradasyami. Pandavetya Pitamaha. Gramam Senam Jadasam Jad. Swalpam Thamyam Api Prabhu. I will not give them anything. He's like an angry child because he's cornered. He knows that he's cornered. He then expected them to outlive the 13 years of punishment. That is why 13 years were announced. Chinnathanmahatakarna. Every one of the Maharathas is attacked by Arjuna. The bow and arrow of Karna have fallen. Chinnathanma Tatkarna Shakti Chikshepa Vegavan Tam Shakti Samarepartha Chikshepa Nishinaisarayi. The Shakti Astra that was also destroyed. And as it's an unforgettable scene here, Dronacharya is being attacked. And Drona knows that he is about to be defeated. But being a very special disciple of Drona, Arjuna creates a gap. Are you following? He creates an artificial gap and says, you may escape. I am not watching. Give him a big hand. Bhishma tells Drona, don't you know that he saved your life by creating a gap for you to go? How can he attack his master? How can he attack? He knows he's a good master with a bad boss. He has nothing against Dronacharya. The man who taught him archery, the man who made him a samisacharya, he says, go. Please. Antaram pradadavupatra dronasya upasarpitum. Beautifully, relatively to Sora bit where Mahabharata is concerned, antaram, a small gap was created and Drona was asked to escape. Drona has escaped for his life. He did not want to be caught now. He's gone. All of them are gone, one by one. And what is our great hero doing? Wait. I've got a very pleasant task to perform. What is he doing? He's carrying all the turbans of the defeated kings. That is his trophy. On the battlefield, you leave your turban because you are defeated. All colorful turbans. He's collecting all of them. So many have been defeated by the great master whom I have been happy to associate with. So all the turbans in on the ground, you can imagine the comic scene. Our man, very innocent fellow, very innocent, lovable, Rashmin, Samutritya, Tato, Mahatma. What did he do? Ratha, Avakrutya, Virakaputraha, Vastran, Upadaya, Maharathana, Nana Vidhani, Adbhutakar, Varnakani. They were lovely, different types and varieties and designs of turban. All of them he collected and said, Uttara Kumara is telling Arjuna, these are the men who are defeated, sir. These are the men who are defeated. Turn your camera to the other side. Word reaches Virata that Viratanagara has won. There's an argument between Kanka and Kanka the entertainer and Virata. Virata says, my son fought bravely. Kanka says, stop this nonsense. It was Brahmanadavan. My son won.
Brahmanadavan.
My son won. Brahmanadavan.
Come, you find the king gets angry, takes a bit of dice, throws it.
Face of Yudhishthira and the nose starts bleeding. Mother Draupadi is watching from behind the scenes. She comes running and holds the edge of her garment before the drop of blood can reach the ground. The king is asking, audacious maid, what is the relationship between my entertainer and a stranger woman?
She says, stop talking.
He's so holy, formidably holy. If one drop of his blood falls on your ground, for 12 years you will have no rainfall, my dear, you will have no rain.
Oh, yeah.
श्रीवासु रूपम इंद्रस्य हरयम् विराटो कृपते श्रीमान् सौभद्राय अभिमन्यवे अभिमन्यु इज लवली चाइल्ड ऑफ सुभद्रा एंड अर्जुना इज नाउ गिवन उत्तरा द ब्यूटिफुल प्रिंसेस ऑफ विराट तां सुतां उत्तरां दत्त्वा because he is now associated with the Pandava family. We come to the end of today's episode. May the Lord fulfill all your heart desires. Please bless me as long as I live. Let me carry this message of faith and grace wherever I go. Yet the Yogeshwar Krishna is the one that you love.